in a land. They can play a bugle call like you never heard before. So natural that you wanna go to war. It's just the best this band will have. Oh, honeyland, come on along, come on along. Let me take you by the hand. Up to the man, up to the man, who is the leader of the band. And if you wanna hear that Swanee River, play it in ragtime, come on here. What we planned. Come on along, come on along. Hey, look at who we've got on hand. Mr. George Ma Harris is on the bill. George Ma Harris! Come on along, come on along, everybody, there's no turning back. Come on along, come on along, and meet a fella name of Jack.
George Maharis, Jack Carter, and the Dillers.
Good evening, and welcome back. You know, one of the most exciting things about doing a weekly television show is just showing up. Is to be able to work with people I've always wanted to work with. And tonight, we've got George Ma Harris. I won't embarrass him by reciting his list of credits, 'cause he can really sing as well as that.
Judy, it's so nice to be with you.
Be my guest,
sure
be
will.
My guest.
Yeah, and later could we sing a song or two?
Together, sure.
Yeah, love it.
Be my guest, be okay. My guest. And we've got Jack Carter, an added starter. He makes me laugh so much I can hardly speak.
Yeah, well, I've been breaking up at him all week.
Yes. Have I got a joke for you?
Uh-oh. Be my guest, be my guest.
But Judy, this joke is on you. Will it be fun for you?
Be my guest, be my guest.
Uh-oh. Judy, you mean to tell me that you don't mind if I do a little bit of a joke on you?
No, no, you can do or say anything you want to on this show.
Wait a minute, you mean to say that after being on those, on the television all those years, driving behind that steering wheel all over the country, I can finally do what I want to do?
Certainly, certainly.
Well, thanks.
You mean that's what you always wanted to do? Sleep?
I wasn't sleeping.
Your eyes were closed.
No, my eyes were open. The lids were closed.
The lids were.
Did I say that wrong or something?
That's incredible. That's incredible. I never heard of such quiet freedom on television. Are you on the level?
Be my guest. You know,
well, here's what I've always wanted to do. Hark, 'tis the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and smoke Juliet, because she's lying drunk in a balcony. Romeo never showed up.
Jack,
and
what are you doing?
What I've always wanted to do, I always wanted to rewrite Shakespeare. Wow, George, we're going to have a ball.
Right, can we do impersonations?
Can we make some accusations?
Hey, you're acting like relations.
We're your guests.
Uncle George.
And Aunt Jack.
Can I swing on the trapeze?
Can I juggle on my knees?
Can I sing and dance?
Act, play.
Hey, I wanted you to be my guest, not my pest.
Oh, Judy, Judy, you're not going to back out on us now.
Isn't that just like a woman?
Yeah, but a very beautiful woman.
And a very talented one. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Be my guest.
No, we'll be back later.
Well, I get guest stars, and when I got them, I gotta let them do what they wanna do. By the way, the same thing goes for you and you and you. You're the the people I want to invite. Won't you join in? There's a party tonight. Why don't you really relax and be mine again? We'll be back a little later. And, of course, Jerry Van Dyke is on hand, too. Yes? Is there something you want to say? Look, boys, it's obvious you got lost from a tour of CBS, right? Now, if you go right over there, you'll find the guy. See, the little green hat, you see? He'll get you back with the tour, and you'll see the whole building. Off you go, right? Yeah, he'll take it. Good, fine. Now, as I was saying, George Maharis and Jack Carter will be back with us later. Look, fellas, enough of this trick-or-treat.
Well, what do you think of the act I brought you, huh?
Act?
Yeah, yeah. Didn't I tell you to stick with me? I'd make you a TV star, huh? Do you know what they are?
No, do you?
Kid, don't you know anything about television at all?
Well,
they're the biggest thing on television right here.
Don't tell me they're doctors.
Kid, these are the Dillards. The Dillards, they're hillbillies.
Well,
that's what the people want to see nowadays. They want to see hillbillies right here.
Yeah,
that's
all
it.
Right. Well, what'll I do with them?
What do you do? They play. They play and they sing. That's it. They play all the musical instruments.
Why don't you just ask them then what they'd like to sing? Maybe we could just...
Sure, sure.
Ask them, that's right.
Sure. Okay, I'll do it. Okay, kids, what do you want to sing? Yeah.
Did they pick out a number? Yeah, you too, Jerry. Look, Jerry, why don't you take me over to Mort Lindsay and they'll pick out a number. You can go along. There you go.
Come on.
Whoa, you know, that's catching. Breaking heart, and I agree that you and I can never be. So with my very best, I set you free. I wish you shelter from a storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm, the most most of all, when shadows fall, I wish you you free. I wish you shelter from a storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm, but most of all, when snowflakes fall,
I would like to register a small complaint.
All right, Don, go ahead.
Well, why is it when a singer is on a show, a guest, they give him special lights, sets, dancers, choirs? They treat him like visiting royalty, you know? But a comedian, they just shove him out there alone to tell his jokes. Now, why can't comedians get that same elegant treatment?
Well, I told you, on my show, you can do what you want. Just ask for it, Don.
Really?
Of course. Go, Jack. Go ask for anything you want. You'll get it.
Oh, anything I want,
anything
Judy?
Anything you want, baby.
Really?
I mean it. Go, Jack.
You're a pal, Jude. Anything I want, huh? Okay. I want dancers. I want singers.
Do we?
I want scenery. More money.
Beyond the drums and blow the horns, roll out the big red carpet. You can forget the other drums, idioms, this one's our pet. When he's doing comedy, we go wow, wow, wee. They just laugh until we cry. Every other comic step aside. He is the greatest in the game. And Jack Carter, Jack Carter, Jack Carter. You've got the ball, now wake us up, cause you kill us, thrill us, fill us with such joy, Jackie. You're our boy.
I got one.
He's got one.
A funny thing happened.
A funny thing happened.
On my way.
It happened on his way.
A funny thing happened on my way to the studio just the other day. Well, this car was driving along the highway, see? Kind of weaving in and out, and a cop pulled the car over, dragged the people out and said, all right, who was driving? And the guy said, nobody was driving, officer. We were all in the back seat singing.
You kill us, thrill us. Jack, you really are born. Tell us an elephant story. Everybody's telling elephant stories.
I've got an elephant story you never heard before.
This'll really make us roar.
This elephant.
Stop! You're laughing already.
This elephant.
Man, you're killing us.
I can't get a word in edgewise.
Shh.
I've got a story that's the best. This one will pass that comic test. This gag will really top the rest.
We're hanging on your every word.
Have you heard about the mockingbird? Well, it wasn't a mockingbird, it was an elephant. And he was tending bar, an elephant. Here he is with his little feet and his horn and his trunk serving drinks.
And a guy walked in and said, oh, no.
And the elephant said, surprised to see an elephant tending bar?
And the guy said, no, I'm surprised that cow sold the place. Cow sold the place. See, it's kind of, it was really an elephant and the cow. What happened? What happened to my little people? Look at this judgment at Nuremberg. Was it something I said? I'm using a man's deodorant. I can't. 5 years ago, wouldn't have lived anyhow. What is it, children? Here. Oh, this is enough. Off to Disneyland. I'm through with you. Everybody out. I don't need you. That's it. I'll work alone. Became a disaster area. See, all you gotta have is a stage and wonderful people. You don't need all that paraphernalia. Like Danny Thomas. The man comes out and stands there all alone, and he's a big smash. And Jack Benny works alone, just walks out with that wonderful style and says, well, Mary, Dennis, Phil, Rochester, play Phil, play Rochester, Mary. It's not a show, it's a roll call. And Tig Jolson, there was a star, came out on a bare stage and didn't even need a microphone. The man was a powerhouse. He came out and he sang, and people got to their feet cheering and yelling. Get a mic, Al, we can't hear you, kid. That's what's going on today. You know the real trouble with show business today? The women are taking over. Hazel Show, Imogene Coca, The Farmer's Daughter. Of course, that show will go on for years. The writer is a traveling salesman, you know. Oh, sure. Lucy. And, of course, Dinah Shore quit, but she sold her smile to Ed Sullivan. And Judy. Of course, Judy is beautiful. Judy Garland. This isn't the original, you know. This is the 12th Judy Garland. You know that. Oh, that's not... You think that's her? Oh, no. Replica. That's it. Oh, she went over the rainbow years ago. There's a little farm in Pasadena that grows Judy Garland. They sent me. That's beautiful, doesn't it? But she's tough. Oh. But the women run everything. Judy, I took her to lunch yesterday after rehearsal. She said, Jack, don't treat me as a woman. I want to be treated as an equal. I said, okay. I slapped her in the back, put a cigar in her mouth, and gave her the check. Women are taking over everything. Everything. It used to be Ben Casey and Kildare. Now it's the nurses. And I like Ben Casey. Boy, there is really a dirty bookmaker, you know? There is really a medical racehorse truck. Hey, I think I'll do a little brain surgery right here. Well, first thing, I better sterilize the instrument. Here we go. And then Zorba runs in. I just had my hair done. Hello, did you have it hair done regular? No, I just stuck my finger in the socket. There we go. Of course, I love the nurses because they had a cute scene last week where this little old nurse was walking in the streets, one of those little visiting nurses of America, with her little surgical feet walking all over. She saw a man lying on the highway on his stomach. She said, oh, goodness, he's passed out. He's hurt, passed out from the heat. While she was sitting on him, jumped right in his back as she was giving him artificial respiration. Pressing, pumping, out with the bad air, in with the good. Pressing, pumping, pushing, working, out with the bad air, in with the good. I'm Florence Nightingale. I work in rain or hail. I'm with the bad and with the good. Die, die, die. I hope he doesn't die. You feel better, mister? Man looked up and said, lady, I don't know what the heck you're doing. I'm putting a wire down a manhole. That's the problem. Years ago, it was a man's world. The beginning of time, the Bible tells us that Adam ruled the primeval world alone. Adam walked as king of the jungle. But the Lord knew this would not go on for long, so he took a rib and he created Eve. And when Adam saw Eve, he flipped his prehistoric wig. But there was no language. He didn't know what to sue. He didn't know what to do. See, hi, ho, ha. Dee-dee-doo-dah. He looked at her and he didn't know what to say. He just went, ugh. And she looked at him and she went, uh-uh. Even then they knew. It's a good thing he didn't run into a snake first. We'd have all been snakes today. Our network is on now. But that was it. They lived together in the Garden of Eden and they were happy. She'd pick him an apple for breakfast, an apple for lunch, an apple for dinner. And ever since then, women have been picking and picking and picking. Then one day he came home late from the jungle. She said, where were you? You're not true to me. There's another woman. He said, there's no other woman here. Count my ribs. say, you're not a bad crowd, see? You can work alone in showbiz, but there's one thing you've got to have. No matter what kind of performer, you've got to have a big finish. And I need a big finish now. Where are my set scenery? Where are my little people? I want them.
Beat on the drums and blow the horns, we're back upon the track now. His monologue began to bog down and he wants us back now.
Kids, I love your company, cause when you're surrounding me, if a joke I tell should die, 30 other people are as guilty as I.
We're more than glad to share the blame.
But if you dazzle them with footwork and you stun them with a song, anything I do here just can't go wrong.
You're too modest, you can make us laugh the whole day long.
I love to do the garland shows, cause when you do the garland shows, anything goes.
Along that has a certain kind of modest.
Oh, Jake, Ed, we're ready. Come on, gang. Come on, here we go. There we go.
Did they pick a song?
Boy, we picked a great song, Judy, and you're really gonna love them. Honest, sweetie, you're really gonna love them.
Yeah.
They're so exciting, so stimulating, so vibrant.
Don't tell me, tell them. I think they need that kind of thing.
You'll have to excuse them, Judy, honest, because they're so excited about being on your show, they can't contain themselves.
Well, they seem to be doing very well at containing themselves. They're containing themselves a little too
long. No, really, they want to sing so badly that they're willing to give up their regular work, honest.
What do they do?
They're auctioneers.
What do you really think they want to sing, Jerry?
It's a beautiful song. It's what? A beautiful song, honest, Judy.
What's the name
of it? It's a beautiful song, isn't it? Isn't it beautiful? It's really something. It's a favorite of theirs, too, right? Good favorite of yours? It's called Goodbye.
Darling, I'm sorry, but George Maharis is going to sing that song.
George Maharis going to sing Goodbye?
Yes.
Fellas, go on. We'll play some more charades in a minute. Go on. When's it going to sing?
Well, as a matter of fact, just about now. See, that's pretty sneaky. Way to get into that, huh? A nice little old lady like me.
You're learning. You're a learning kid.
You told me.
But that was long ago. Now you've forgotten, I know. No use to wonder why. Let's say farewell with a sigh. Just let love die. But we'll go on living our own way of living. So you take the high road and I'll take the low. time that we parted. It's much better so. But kiss me as you go. Goodbye. Let's say farewell with a sigh. Just let love die. But we'll go on living. Our own way of living. So you take the high road and I'll take the low. It's time that we parted. It's much better so. But kiss me as you go. Goodbye.
Thanks, Judy. I've got all yours, too, but I'm glad it worked out okay, because, to be perfectly frank, I kind of have a heck of a time singing a song out of context, you know.
What do you mean, Dad?
Well, take a Broadway show like My Fair Lady, Rex Harrison singing I've Grown Accustomed to Your Face. Mm-hmm. You know, they built a whole play around it, and, you know, by the time he got to the song, you know, he was kind of accustomed to her face, you know, but...
Yeah.
I'm lost here. But anyway, you know what happens when you go to into a studio and you have to sing? How do you get yourself to believe the lyric?
Well, I make up a story to make myself believe the lyric. Yes, I do. I make up a story all of my... Let me try one on you, let's see.
Go.
Method lyrics, okay?
Method, right. Well,
you're in a penthouse.
All right.
In Acapulco.
Oh, great. Love that.
You've got a smoking jacket on, glass
right.
of champagne.
Right.
Yeah. Moonlight night, and... There's a knock at the door.
Yeah.
The door opens and she comes in.
Right.
You take her in your arms, and you kiss her. And then there's a knock at the door again, and he comes in and with a gun in his hand. And
I got it.
What?
The party's over.
Right.
It's time to call it a day.
See, it works.
Yeah, it's great. I got it. Let me try one on you.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
You're madly in love with me.
I am? All right.
But I don't love you.
Well, wait a minute. Why not?
Well, you know, I just don't love you, that's all. I'm mean, I'm cruel. I treat you like a dog.
That's all right.
I don't work. I don't support you.
That's all right. I'll support both of us.
Yeah, but I drink. I gamble. I'm no good. I'm rotten. I'm cruel. How could you love a man like me?
Well, I'll force myself.
But I'm broke.
I'll be broke with you, okay?
Now we ain't got a barrel of
money.
Maybe we're ragged and funny.
But we'll travel along, singing a song,
side by side.
Now you don't know what's coming tomorrow. Or the day after.
Maybe it's trouble and sorrow.
But we'll travel the road,
sharing a load,
side by side.
Now through all kinds of weather, what if the sky should fall?
What if the sky
just
should fall?
Just as long as we're together.
Yeah.
It doesn't really matter at all when they've all had their quarrels and parted. What
will
if we're
the same if we started? We'll
along,
travel,
we'll
travel side by side.
Second half of the Judy Garland Show is brought to you by Crest, the toothpaste proved effective against cavities in year after year of clinical tests, tests among thousands of families in homes like yours.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Leo DeRocher. He's with the Brooklyn Dodgers.
Hold. Brooklyn Dodgers? Los Angeles Dodgers, please, Judy. Formerly with the Brooklyn Dodgers. We have moved west.
I see.
Say, Judy, this is a beautiful tea service
you
have here.
Do you want to have some tea with me?
Oh, no, I never touch the stuff, no.
Well, let's talk about baseball.
Okay.
I'm really rather stupid about it. Can you tell me?
No.
Something about the... Well, there must be a lot of tension amongst the players now. Coming into this.
Sometimes there is, Judy. The players get... any player that tells you that his hands, you know, they don't get wet before a big game, he's lying. There's plenty of tension, like there was when we played the St. Louis Cardinals here just a few days ago, and now the World Series. Until the first ball is pitched, there's plenty of tension. And I want to tell you a cute story about a certain ball player who I think is one of the great players of all time, and that's Willie Mays.
Yeah, please.
You know that name, I'm sure.
He's with the Dodgers, the Brooklyn Dodgers. He's with the team.
Yes, the San Francisco Giants, Judy. But this is a cute kid, and he came up to the Giants. It was then the New York Giants, and I was the manager of the ball club, and this boy went 24 times to bat and never hit the ball out of the infield. Strike out, pop up, many chances to win me a ball game, couldn't do it. And we finally were beaten a ball game 1-0 in the Polo Grounds by the then Boston Braves. And I came in the clubhouse mad at everybody, kicking the door down, you know, throwing
unusual
things.
Unusual for you.
That's right. And I kicked one shoe off and I was about to kick the other one into the wall, and my coaches ran at me and they said, Skip, you better go talk to your boy. And I says, what's wrong with him? I was mad, too, at him. You know, he said, he's crying. I said, crying about what? Well, he's crying. You better go down and talk to him. So I took my other shoe off, went down, and there he was, sitting in front of his locker, just sobbing, tears coming down. And I put my arm around. I said, what's wrong, Willie? And at this time, he used to talk in a high tenor voice. And this is his answer to me. He said, Mr. Leo. He said, I can't hit. I can't help anybody. I can't help you win the ball. I know I'm not good enough to play up here. And you're going to send me back to Minneapolis? That's where I belong. I put my arm around him, and I said, Willie, as long as I'm the manager of this ball club, you're going to play center field tomorrow, next week, next month, and just as long as I'm here. Now go home, get a good night's sleep, forget about it. Tomorrow's a new day.
Yeah.
The very next day, Judy, the great Warren Spahn pitching, first ball he threw him over the top of the roof, and from then on, he carried us into the pennant.
Oh, that's lovely.
He's a great player. Great player. And there are so many things, Judy, that it takes, you know, to become a great player. The things that I call are five great things, basic things.
What are they?
Well, you must hit with power, run, field, and throw.
Yeah.
Mays is the only man today in baseball that I believe can do all five and do them better than any other man we have in baseball.
That's
Joe DiMaggio was the last one. This is the other one.
That's marvelous. You know, you and I have something in common. Because you get very mad at umpires, don't you?
Oh, what? Then you mean the men in blue?
Yes. Well,
once in a while.
I used to get mad at the men in blue at MGM, you know. But I never had enough nerve to kick them in the shins the way you did. Didn't you kick a couple of umpires? I'd like to
just
kick
one.
A couple of executives in my days. But tell me about when you kicked the...
Well, you know, when you get thrown out of a game, I can't tell you exactly, Judy, the language, because you want to stay in the air, don't you? I can't tell you. But I'll tell you, I did, in the Coliseum a few years ago, getting into an argument with Jocko Conlon, and he threw me out of the game for using a little language that was a little off color. Now that I'm out of the game, I thought I'd give it to him good. And the one thing that they hate to have you do to them is kick dirt on their blue suit.
Dirt?
Yeah. So, you know, I got right down close to him.
That's so funny.
And I stood there, and I kicked dirt with my spike, and it flew up on his pants. And he, in turn, tried to kick dirt back at me, and he kicked me right in the shins. And I kicked him in the shins, and he kicked me, and I kicked him. Like two banty roosters were kicking one another, and of course it cost me $500 in 3 days. And then it dawned on me, he had shin guards on, and I didn't. I was I got suspended and got fined $500 for that. There's a rule in baseball, Judy. You can't touch the blue suit.
No?
Touch it. And they say, you touch that suit and you're out of here. I said, I'm not touching you. You're running into me. I always accuse them of bumping into me, Judy. I'm never running into them.
Listen, you know something I know about you. You can sing. You can
sing?
Sing? Yes. You know a song.
Uh-uh. You can't. Everybody on this show sing?
Sing a song for me, will you?
Me sing a song?
Yeah.
No chance.
What about meet me in St. Louis?
We just got through with the St. Louis Blues. They got the blues now. We just got through with them, Judy.
I'm a Yankees doodle dandy. You can...
So we're having enough trouble with the Yankees right now. I'll tell you.
Your song.
Sing something that, you know, that I know the words to, like, take me out to the ball.
Right.
All right?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
Take me out to the ball game.
Take me out with the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I ever get back.
Well, sweetie, how do you like them now, huh?
I can't believe it. Those are the Dillards with their hair combed, and they've got dinner jackets on,
yeah.
and dinner pants, and,
yeah.
And open-toed shoes.
Okay, let's hit it hard, okay? Come on, we gotta do good. One, two, one, two. No,
Grandma had a muley cow, muley when she was born. It took her to every 40 years to fly from horn to horn.
Whoa, mule, whoa, whoa, mule, I say, ain't got time to kiss you now, mule has run away.
Set her on three buzzard eggs, she has not one old crow.
Whoa, mule, whoa, whoa, mule, I say, ain't got time to kiss you now, mule has run away.
Keep your secrets, Liza, just you stay cool. I ain't got time to kiss you now, I'm fiddling with this mule.
Whoa, mule, whoa. Whoa, mule, I say, ain't got time to kiss you now, mule has run away.
It's your turn, why don't you sing?
What's the matter with you? Did you forget the words?
Get your words right. Garland, she'll make up some. You're only bored, you have to make up some.
You better make up some quick.
Her lips are all tobacco juice and her chin ain't never dry. Only USA ain't got time to kiss you now.
We join in together and we'll all rip one off together. You'll come, see us when you can. You'll come,
see us now and then.
When you live in the country, everybody is your neighbor. On this one thing you can rely. But they all come to see you, and they never leave you, saying you'll come to see us by and by. You'll come. Yes, you'll come to see us when you can. You'll come. Yes, you'll all come to see us now and then.
Fishing to claw that hole.
Buddy, oh, buddy, oh, my.
Oh, my. I'll get it.
Oh, forget it.
While I was singing, somebody touched me. While I was singing,
somebody touched me.
While I was singing, somebody touched me. It must have been the hand. Glory, glory, glory,
somebody touched me.
Glory, glory, glory,
somebody touched me.
Glory, glory, glory,
somebody touched me. It must have been the hand of our Lord.
While I was praying, somebody touched me. While I was praying, somebody touched me. While I was praying, somebody touched me. It must have been the hand of our Lord. Glory, glory, glory,
somebody touched me.
The gustiest, the winds are the gustiest, the gates are the rustiest, the pies the crustiest, the songs the lustiest, the friends the trustiest way back home. The trees are the sappiest, the days are the nappiest, the dogs are the yappiest, the kids are the scrappiest, the jokes the snappiest, the folks the happiest way back home.
I got a gal all over Sunday, then I got another for Monday. Ain't nobody's business but my own. I got another just sits at home, just sitting there by the telephone. Ain't nobody's business but my own. Nobody's business. Nobody's business. Nobody's business but my own. Nobody's business. Ain't nobody's doggone business. Nobody's business but my own. My own. My own. My own.
Saw the holy number way in the middle of the air. Boo! John saw the holy number way in the middle of the air. Look away over yonder, what I see way in the middle of the air. There's a holy angel coming after me way in the middle of the air. John saw the holy number way in the middle of the air. Woo! John saw
the holy number
way in the middle of the air.
Way over yonder, what do I see?
Way in the middle of the air.
A holy angel coming after me
way in the middle of the air. John saw the holy number way in the middle of the air. Woo!
John's on the holy number, way in the middle of the air. But way over yonder do I see, way in the middle of the air. There's all the angels come at me, way in the middle of the air. Way in the middle of the air. You're gone,
you're gone,
you're gone,
you're gone.
Oh, you all go and leave us on our own. You're gone,
you're gone,
you're gone,
you're gone.
Oh, you all go and leave us all alone. You're gone,
you're gone,
you're gone,
you're gone.
Oh, you all go and leave us on our own. You're gone,
you're gone.
Oh, you all go and leave us on our own. Oh, you all go and leave us all alone.
Faithful trunk and me. You know, everything in this trunk has memories for me. Some good and some bad, but they're memories nevertheless. Let's see what we have here this week. There's one top drawer. This drawer, I can't get it open, and I can never find the key. I wonder what's in there. Maybe it's a weight I lost. What else we got? What is that? I've got to tell you about this. This is my boa. And I remember during one of the concerts, when I was doing concert tour, I wanted to look really nifty, you know. And my idea of looking nifty has always been to wear a feather boa. So I finally got them to make me one. It looked a little better than this one. I don't know whose this is. I think they should have shot it before I took it out. Anyway, I came on to sing a kind of gentle Noel Coward song, a sophisticated drawing room type song, and I wrapped the bow around me and started singing, and breathed the whole bow. And it was so terrible. Look at you see that it's happening right now. I think I'm really better off with the old songs, because nice little old ladies like me are just better off with the old songs.
Yeah, way.
Johnny, how I love you, how I love you. My dear, I give the world to me. I love the folks in T-I-X. I even know my mammy is waiting for me, praying for me down by the The folks up north will see me no more when I get to that Swanee shore. Swanee, Swanee, I'm coming back to Swanee. Mammy, Mammy, I love the old folks at home. I love you, Swanee. I'd give the world if I could only be sitting on my mammy's knee. I love the old folks, I love the young folks. Oh, my honey lamb, you love more than Alabama. Mammy, Mammy, my dear old Mammy, your wonder child will wonder no more when I get to that Swanee.
Come back one year.
elephant roosting the trees. I will come back when the birds make off to the bees. I will come back when the sun refuses to shine. Hunt Stromberg Jr. is a cousin of mine. I will come back walk around at 2 feet and promenade up and down on Washington Street. When the snow has turned from white to blue, then baby, when I will come back to you, yeah!
Has been brought to you by Crest, the toothpaste proved effective against cavities in year after year of clinical tests. Tests among thousands of families in homes like yours.
One of the most exciting things about doing a weekly television show is showing up. Is being able to work with so many people that I've wanted to work with all my life and I've never had the opportunity before. But tonight, we've got George Maharis. I won't embarrass him by reciting his list of credits, 'cause he can really sing as well as that.
It's nice to be with you.
Be my guest, be my guest.
I sure will. Hey, later, could we sing a song or two?
Together, yeah.
Yeah,
be my guest, be my guest.
All right, I will.
We've got Jack Carter, an added starter. He makes me laugh so much I can hardly speak.
I've been breaking up at him all week. I got
Judy, have I got a joke for you? Well, wait a minute. Look, now this one's on you. Will it be fun for you?
Be my guest. Be my guest.
Judy, you mean to tell me you don't mind if I tell a little joke on you, baby?
No. Anything you want to do or say on this show is all right with me, you know.
Wait a minute. You mean to say that after all those years driving on television, I can do what I want?
Yes, darling. And be my guest.
Well, thanks.
Is that what you wanted to do all your life? Sleep?
Oh, I wasn't sleeping.
Your eyes were closed.
Oh, no, my eyes were open. The lids were closed.
This is incredible. I never heard of such freedom on television. Are you on the level?
Me? Yes. Be my guest.
Step back. Here's something I've always wanted to do. Hark! What light through yonder window brings. 'Tis the east and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair Juliet. Get off the balcony, you drunken bum. Get off of that. We'll get a pastrami sandwich and hot rye bread.
What are you doing, Jack?
Well, I was just rewriting Shakespeare. That's what I've always wanted to do. Hey, this is a ball.
Can we do impersonations?
Can we make some accusations?
Hey, you're acting like relations.
We're your guests.
Uncle George.
And Aunt Jack.
Can I sweep with the bees?
Can I juggle on my knees?
Can I sing and dance?
Act, play.
Hey, I asked you to be my guest, not my pest.
Oh, Judy, you're not going to back out on us now, are you?
Not just like a woman.
Yeah, but a very beautiful woman.
And a very talented one,
Be my guest.
Great. We'll see you later.
Well, I get guest stars, and when I get them, I got to let them do what they want to do. By the way, the same thing goes for you and you and you. You're the people I want to invite. Won't you join in? There's a party tonight. Why don't you really relax and be my guest? Jack Carter will be back a little later. And, of course, we have Jerry Van Dyke, who will be joining us. Yes? Is there something you want to say? Look, fellas, I it's obvious you got lost on a tour through CBS. So just go over there and you'll find a guide, see? And he'll help you find your way around the building with the rest of the tour. Off you go, right? Oh, see that? Yes, good. Okay, as I was saying, George Maharis and Jack Carter and... Look, enough of this trick-or-treat business.
Well. What do you think of the act I brought you, huh?
The act?
Yeah. Didn't I tell you to stick with me? I'd make you a big TV star, huh? Well, do you know who they are?
No. Do you?
Don't you know anything about television, honey? They're the biggest thing on television.
Don't tell me they're doctors.
Kid, they're the Dillards. They're hillbillies.
Uh-huh.
That's what the people want to see. Hillbillies, no kidding. Yeah?
Well, what'll I do with them?
What are you gonna do? Sweetie, they play musical instruments and they sing.
What do you mean they sing? They don't even talk.
You just don't know how to talk to them, that's all.
Oh, I couldn't. Maybe if I just try. Why don't we just ask them what kind of number they want to do?
Sure.
Okay,
huh?
Go ahead.
Okay. What number would you like to do, fellas?
Well, did they pick out a number? Oh, no. It's happened to you too, eh, Jerry? Look, why don't you take your friends here and go off to Mort Lindsay and pick out a song, and everything will be all right. Off you go.
All right.
Away we go. Hippity hop. Well, it's catching. Breaking heart, and I can see that you and I can never be. to keep you warm. But most of all, when snowflakes fall, I wish you. My very best, I set you free. I wish you shelter from a storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm, the most of all. When snowflakes fall, I wish you
exciting things about doing a weekly television show is showing up. I mean, is being able to work with some of the people I've always wanted to work with. And tonight, just think, we've got George Maharis. I won't embarrass him by reciting his list of credits, because he can really sing as well as act. Stars, and when I get them, I've gotta let them do what they wanna do. By the way, the same thing goes for you and you and you. You're the people I want to invite. Why don't you come and join us up tonight? Why don't you really? Let's stop it.
Here we go.
What's a, give me a bell note, Mom.
Well, what do you think of now? What do you think of now? Look, huh?
Those are the Dillards? I can't believe it. Their hair is combed. They've got their dinner jackets on, dinner trousers on. Oh. And open-toed shoes.
Okay, fellas, let's hit it, and let's hit it hard, okay? One, two, one, one, no, one, two, no, huh? One, here we go, one, one. You try it, I don't know.
Grandma had a muley cow, muley when she was born. It took a jaybird 40 years to fly from horn to horn.
Whoa, mule, whoa, whoa, mule, I say, ain't got time to kiss you now, muley, run away.
Set her on three buzzard eggs, she hatched that one old crow.
Whoa, mule, whoa, whoa, mule, I say,